Exploring the wonders of algebra. I am Aisyah Nur Adila, your host for today. I also would like to greet the Governor of Indonesian Mathematical Society for Central Java and DIY Regency, Dr. Bagus Ardi Saputro, the Chair of Indonesian Algebra Society of Central Region, Dr. Niken Prima Puspita, SSE MSc, the Dean of Faculty of Sciences and Mathematics, Professor Dr. Widowati, SSE MSc, the Head of Department of Mathematics, Dr. Susilo Haryanto, SSE MSc, lecturers of Department of Mathematics FSM Undip, our distinguished speaker for Aligarh Muslim University, Professor Syakir Ali, our moderator, and all participants. Ladies and gentlemen, lecture series is held in collaboration with Indonesian Mathematical Society, IndoMS, Indonesian Algebra Society, Universitas Negeri Semarang, Universitas Islam Negeri Wali Songo, and Universitas PGRI Semarang. Today's series is the first out of three series which will be held throughout today and tomorrow. Make sure to keep updated for the upcoming series. For the next 3 hours together, we will discuss it. Today's series will be held in one session and a moderator to elaborate the topic. Ladies and gentlemen, please allow me first to read the agenda for today. The first agenda is the opening session. The second agenda is lecture session led by our moderator. The next agenda is wording session, and the last agenda is closing. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now in the opening session. Without further ado, I would like to invite the member of International Office of Faculty of Sciences and Mathematics, Panji Triadeksa, SSE MSc PhD, for give the opening speech and open this lecture session.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Our honorary speaker, Dr. Syakir Ali, and also faculty member of mathematics in the faculties of science and mathematics, Diponegoro University, all students of mathematics in the faculty. Thank you very much for your attendance to today's meeting. First of all, I would like to sincerely give our apology to Dr. Syakir due to our dean cannot attend today's agenda because the dean and also the vice dean has a meeting with the rector at this morning. We are apology for that, but we welcome Dr. Syakir to Undip, to Semarang, to give a talk about exploring the wonder of algebra. We hope that by this event, we will have a new insight about algebra and help our students to explore more about algebra and its applications in the daily work. And therefore, without further overdo, we would like to open these sessions with Bismillah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We hope that this event will be successful and will be beneficial to all of us. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you for Mr. Panji Triadeksa, SSE MSc PhD, for open this lecture session. Ladies and gentlemen, before the main session, I would like to invite all of you to join together on the stage for a group photo session. For the offline participants, please come here to join the group photo session. And for the online participants, please turn on your camera. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now we have come to our main agenda, the lecture session. All presentation and discussion will be moderated by our moderator, Muhammad Syahid. Allow me to read his short bio. Muhammad Syahid is an undergraduate student at the Department of Mathematics. Currently, he is the finalist of Mathematics Olympiad 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome our moderator, Muhammad Syahid.
For Miss Aisha, give me time now. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Honorable the Governor of Indonesian Mathematical Society for Central Java and the IE Regency, Dr. Bagus Ardi Saputro, the Chair of Indonesian Algebraic Society of Central Region, Dr. Niken Prima Puspita, the Dean of Faculty of Science and Mathematics, Professor Dr. Widowati, SSE, MSE, the Head of Department of Mathematics, Dr. Susilo Haryanto, Lecturer of Department of Mathematics, Faculty of Science and Mathematics, Universitas Diponegoro, our distinguished speaker from Aligarh Muslim University, India, Professor Dr. Shakir Ali, and all participants. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Muhammad Syahid. It gives me a great pleasure to be in the moderator for the lecture series, Exploring the Wonder Algebra. As we know, abstract algebra is a mathematical subject area that studies algebraic structures, such as group theory, modulus theory, ring theory, and others. What we learn in the class is a small part of algebra. So in today's, we are going to exploring the wonder of algebra. Ladies and gentlemen, before we continue, I'd like to read a brief introduction of our series speaker. He is Professor Shakir Ali. He is a lecturer in the Aligarh Muslim University, India. Can scroll. He get a title professor at Department of Mathematics, Aligarh Muslim University at February 7, 2019 till date. Okay, and he is more than that teaching experience, more than 20 years until science 2000 entry, and have research experience more than 24 years since 1999. And he has research publication more than 100. Okay. Before the presentation begins, let me tell you how this workshop will run. Firstly, the speaker will present the material for about 2 hours. And after that, we will have a question and answer session about 20 minutes. Let us welcome to our speaker, Professor Dr. Shakir Ali.
Well, dear academic friends, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm glad to see you all in this morning. And at this outset, first to say thanks, many of you who make this morning video. And of course, first, one of your eminent algebraists and the president of Indonesian Math Society, Professor Inda Imla Vijayanti, who invited me to visit her university. But by the way, his group across the country is requesting me one way, another way to come my university. So this is my fourth place in the Indonesia. I start my journey from India to Dubai for 1B, then from Dubai to Morocco, North America, to attend an international conference on algebra and its application, and we have some cooperation over there. So we at least 1 week in Morocco, Casablanca, and then back to again Dubai, and then again to Delhi, and from Delhi to Malaysia, Malaysia to Jakarta. So I was Jakarta University of Indonesia for 5 days, and then go to Bandung to visit Professor Intan and his algebra team, and then move to University of Gajdamada to attend SEAMS UGM International Conference, and have several discussions with the rector and faculty members of Faculty of Natural Science and Mathematics. I have good experience and good memories when I return back, I hope, inshallah. And now I am with you. So thanks, Professor Dr. Nikhin, for inviting me to see this beautiful place and to interact all of brilliant future of this Indonesia. So really, I'm glad to you. Now, let me come towards the scientific event. So I was speak on some wonders of algebra, and this topic, sometimes, you know, the topic is asked to the speaker, which topic we choose to speak. But this topic, Nikhin choose without me, without my consult, and he, I think, was so proud to choose this topic, and I would really love to speak on this topic because this is my favorite topic from last 10 years. I will exploring the way how algebra play an important role in today's era. Let me tell the story behind this topic. I was honored to work with one of the best university in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, that is King Abdulaziz University, Jeddah. So I was there for around 5 years, and I was the one of the the coordinator that how to remove, that is title up I told the project, how to remove the phobia from algebra. So this is the task the Saudi King Abdullah University president and the whole team of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia give me assignment, how to handle the people of the Saudi Arabia, because they don't have interest in algebra. So the objective is how we pursue the subject in the future. So could you help me out in this direction? I agreed, and I worked for 5 years. And Alhamdulillah, in the most of the university in the Saudi Arabia, start from Jeddah, King Abdul Aziz University, and King Saud University, Makkah, Umm al-Qura University, and Medina, Taiba University, Zazan, and you know, that means most of the country we have arranged the workshop. That theme is how to create interest among the student in algebra. So that was the big journey and one of the most important part of my life to make awareness. Saudi students are they're not very good in English and they not have much interest, even the male, especially I'm talking. So it's difficult task for me how to handle this. So just I quote a few examples how I remove this phobia. And when was the first day on the workshop, there was around 100 graduate students in the class, and I entered and welcomed the students and just asking the question, what your interest? Just first ask, what is your interest in the topic? So nobody say anybody interest in algebra. Some they have applied mathematics, some say no in business, some they have other. And I was a little bit sad how to manage these people, because nobody have interest in that area. But anyway, then I start, I had like a mobile, I asked people, do you know the application of mathematics in mobile? Then I found some smile on the faces of the student. Means they think, oh, is mathematics is something is here in mobile. Then nobody have the positive answer, but their face is very smiling. I think they have interest in this topic. Then I think, okay, this is the way where we start the journey. So ladies and gentlemen, come back on this topic. This is the issue of the beginning of journey. So when this topic, Nikin has sent me message, this is your flyer, it is okay. Then I say I'm more than okay, because she not asking me about this topic, but she pick up this topic. So and that's means for me, I really feel very happy, because this is my interest. And I work more than 5 years on this issue. So it is good to convey this message and fulfill the desire of Nikin, because she choose this topic. I don't know why he choose. I asked this question, why he choose this topic. Do you have any idea in your mind before pick up this topic, Nikin? Just suddenly? Anyway, it's a very interesting topic. So now we move on the agenda, and then come on one by one. So can you share the please slide? Okay. Much thanks to the university and the administration of this university, like your director and dean, AW Department of Mathematics, CW Society of the Kimagram, and Nikin as well. So thank you very much to our you for giving me this wonderful opportunity to attract the young minds of this beautiful mathematics. So let me give you some brief idea, because you know about me, but before we got to you, I think the first time many of you are not know about my place, which I love so much, because this is the place by which I have now stand in front of you. So I'll let you introduce this beautiful place. In fact, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh, you may be of history, it is one of the oldest universities in okay, now I'm comfortable here. Yes. So, no, I'm comfortable with this. Yeah. Because, so Aligarh Muslim University is started as a Islamic madrasa in the year of 1887. During the time of British. And the founder of this university was building where our university has started in 1857. If you look on that side, this is the building which has the heritage of the British period, because at that time you notice most like example the Oxford University, you have a similar structure. Okay, so that is the memory of that time when the university has started. And then this is the founder's house, Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. And before he...
Yes, Harun.
He is the man who do not have their own home more than 50 years. And he living either in the madrasa or the house of his friend, because to support and to establish this beautiful institution. And after, in the end of the life, he made house with the help of his friend. But this building is the part of AMU. We preserve the history of his contribution and so many things. And that's why we call it Sir Sayyid House. And yes. And then you look on this is the Maulana Azad. This is Central Library, and beauty of this library, it is open 24 hours. Because this is central one. So many students, you know, have the different habit. Some of them, they want to study in the morning, some of them the evening, daytime, or some of them in the night, a late night. So we decide it's open in different setting, and the student can read whatever time is suitable for him or her. And this is because in about the Aligarh Muslim University is, as you told, is big, has more than 115 departments and are around 15 faculties from A to Z, Faculty of Arts and Goan Faculty of Science, Social Science, Life Science, Medicine, United Medicine, like that's law. So it's big. Its area is around 9 kilometers. 9 kilometers. So we have the different gates. So this is the recent gate, and that inaugurated by the Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi. And this is the another building, is the medical college. And then you did the central part. This is what Department of Mathematics. And I am very happy to share with you about this department. It is the department which has, according the Baba of Science, has ranking 96 in the world. from last 10 years, 96, 86, sometime 100. So that is the big achievement. Only the Department of India had such ranking in the world. Okay. And you know, the, according to the Bureau of Science, the three professors are in 2% list. And they are from, you know, the algebra and analysis. So that's why I really feel proud to be announced about this achievement by the faculty members of the department. And at this point, I must be told you the ranking of any university is based on, the key point is the research activities. So if you want to rank of your university in any level, you maintain the research activity more and more. So this is the key parameter about the decision about the ranking of the university. Yeah, so look at this. This is the easier view of university is spread in larger part of the, it is outside the city, but, city Aligarh. And Aligarh, you know, because of this university, and it is outside from the city, but slowly and slowly people come to close. So now look like a big, like a city. Yeah. So this is the India map, and you look map in Delhi. Yes, this part. Okay, this is Uttar Pradesh, means the city in the province of Uttar Pradesh. So here is Aligarh, okay, and it is very near to Delhi. So very near to Delhi, close to Delhi. So this is the small story about the university. And now, because many of you know are eager to know the people of my research team, okay, especially for algebra. So this is the AMU algebra group led by our Dean Faculty of Science, and also is none, is more for me, he was my mentor. So I'm more proud to be put on the top. And of course, he is one of the leader of this group who create the many beautiful things. Now, this is my research collaboration. Alhamdulillah. More than 40 or 45 countries I visited because of the research activities. And it is difficult, you know, survive to other country. But if you have good relation and good people and the things which will be helpful to the others, you really enjoy your stay anywhere. So the research is the key point in my journey, which makes me everything easy. Example in your friend, because I just supposed to come Indonesia to attend this UGM conference, and then it convert the whole month budget to involve in academic activities. Even I have not have a single day, I told you, since from Jakarta, not have a single day for to see the around. Every day, even the Sunday, we are already engaged by the student either in Jakarta or in Bandung or in UGM every day. So this makes me more happy even, because the involvement to utilize the time and the fulfill the desire means my inner feeling about how to support, because Allah has given to me beautiful things, beautiful life, Alhamdulillah. So I want to just share my ideas and really very happy to help if some anyone of research group from algebra or my research scientist is want to discussion or ask me to give a time, I ready to give and always happy to share my ideas and help. So feel free to all of you, any one of you, if need any type of suggestion, any type of discussion on the education, not only India, okay, As your screen is already view, you can talk on these countries where I visited, and alhamdulillah, I have very good circle of my friends across these countries because I was a regular visitor of this country. So many good friends in not only in algebra, in information science, in computer algebra, in analysis. I mean, not only in algebra, because we have good connection also in other areas. So, and then the other point for making the journey are beautiful are the research collaborations. So alhamdulillah, we have several exchange program between India and other countries. So top countries, if you look on top, this is the Canada, US, and the Slovenia. And of course, we have long relation with KU. Still, we have a lot of project with King Abdulaziz University and King Saud University. And we have finished the exchange program Slovenia, Canada, and US, and also Japan. And then now the South Korea, we have already finished. Then it's still Malaysia and Morocco is under consideration. And Turkey also, nowadays we have involved the Turkey guys, Turkey algebraists, on a funded project that is supported by Tubutik, that is the scientific agency supported by the government of Turkey. And then this part, already we have connection with France because we have joint project with France. And then the Norway, we have some collaborations, and Italy as well. So here we have collaboration either as a research exchange programs or with the other activities. So now we will move on the things where you are waiting. So now we come on the issue of today about talking about some of the wonders from algebra. So ladies and gentlemen, the things what I pick up, the four wonders of algebra for today's discussion, okay? So they are on your screen. So inshallah, we come one by one and discuss you. And this is the part of discussion, not this is a technical talk. So you can share your views, and then we make the formal discussion. So first one is first wonder of algebra, we call fundamental theorem of algebra. I hope and believe everyone is aware about this beautiful wonders from algebra. Anyone who have not listened the name, I think this not possible for everyone know, because this is the first wonder I choose. This not from undergraduate or postgraduate. This is start from the schooling. Are you agree? Okay. So your question is, should be, why I pick up this as a wonder? Anyone, please share why this is we call wonder of algebra. Anyone from a student side, because I want to involve more of the students. You know about this fundamental theorem of algebra. It is started since class 6. I don't know here, but in the most of the country, it is started in class 5th and 6th, where you started to study the theory of equations. So it is one of the oldest friend from mathematics and in general, in math, algebra and in general mathematics. So let me talk about this first wonder and why we pick up this. This is the question. So if we come on the mathematical point of view, this is the one of the first fundamental theorem, which, you know, gives information about the roots of the polynomial. It has different statements. Under graduate level, then 10th class, 12th class level, and if you go up, like PG, so we modify the statement. So it has statement depend on the level of students. So I start from class 6th and 7th. Statement. Every polynomial of positive degree has zeros. Or every polynomial of positive degree has roots. Statement from class, that book, from which take first statement from class 6 or 7. I hope you all are aware about the zeros of polynomial, means the roots of the polynomial. So one of the most important part of the mathematics is start from these notions, the solution of theory of equations. How many is polynomial of degree 1? How many solution it has? Polynomial of degree 2? Polynomial of degree 3? Okay, you go up. The next statement of class, from class 10 to 12. Every polynomial of degree n has at most n roots over the field of complex numbers. I repeat, every polynomial of degree n has at most n roots over the field of complex numbers. This is the statement of this class. Move more. The field of complex number is closed. This is the statement from undergraduate classes to PG. So I gave a three statement of same beautiful theorem. Okay, so different statement and different label, but the key point is same at each label, depend on the class, time, according to the need of the people who will take. So this gives the information, in fact, about the roots of non-zero polynomial, how many roots has, and then the other mathematical things are started when we know about this basic point. So that's why, and another point, when we're talking about these roots, the behavior of the roots of the polynomial, if we know these behavior, I mean roots, kind of roots, like, you know, when we're talking about roots is not always, we are talking over real fields. It may be on the complex fields. So it may have some other important observation, what type they are real, they are complex. Okay. So anyhow, this was the one of the wonder from mathematics and in general algebra. And that's why this will, in fact, this fundamental theorem will, you know, algebra more interesting. People will be recognize its importance in several way of life, either go in the natural science, or go in the medical science, or go into informal science, everywhere. Because this basic mathematics everywhere, and every step. So that's why we call first wonder of algebra is fundamental theorem of algebra. Any question? Yes. Okay, if no question, then we should move. Next. Yes. Dn, the ring of integer modulo n. I think this ring, and I'm proudly to mention about this, is the heart of algebra. Heart of algebra, which has not only place in algebra, which changes the shape of the world. Means its place more than from mathematics is in information science, electrical science, electrical engineering, computer science. Are you agree? Yes? How many agree? Please raise your, because I want to discuss this. We have this open discussion. Are you agree? This is what I'm talking. The second wonder from mathematics in algebra is the ring of integer modulo n. I give more weightage, is change the shape of the word. Why? The answer is very simple. Those who are moderator, how many participants today in this lecture? Please check. Sorry? 43 online. Perhaps, I don't know, you know, there are people from India, people from Turkey, people from Morocco, people from Dubai, people from Malaysia, people from, who asked me about this? Yes, but in USA, this is the night, so I think it's not. But the people across the world are listening me as you are listening. So this is what this makes algebra and mathematics more interesting. How this is going on? Anyone from the participants, please? How this is going on? How I'm saying this is the change the shape of the word? In that sense, because it minimizes the distance between India and Indonesia. No matter, I am speaking Indonesia, and my colleague or my students are those who are having interest in my lecture, they are listening. As you are listening, we are together, but they are far away from here. And you know this wonder, how it's important, people are listening. But I still need more about you. How much of you know this wonderful structure we call group, we call ring, and also we call a field. Come on later, but this is what is the beautiful. That's why I pick up the second wonder from mathematics in algebra, the ring of integer modulo n. Now come in particular. In the middle of my talk, I give you the clear-cut information about three applications of this important, beautiful structure. Let me give you name of this structure. which are not in algebra. How people know this about this structure? Number one, those who are not in mathematics, listen carefully. Number one, algebra for science of communication. Algebra for information science. Okay? Boolean algebra for electrical engineers. The light switch off and on. Okay, if we choose this N is 2, later we discuss in more detail. Then you have a ring of integer modulo 2. Okay, where is the board? Could you put board here? Because I need to are somewhere in the middle way. Because it's clear to all of you. Yeah, yeah. So now I'm going to give you the outlook of this beautiful structure. Why we give these names? And what is the role of these names? And why this structure is so popular in information science? More than algebra. You will believe it? This algebraic structure more popular than in algebra or in mathematics in information science. Okay, so let me give you this.
I want to give you one of the most important application of algebra. Mobile, everyone know since morning to evening and use. They in finding the first jumping when you make anything and like you want to sort anything, it's like what we do the red is you just give your logic, you will get OTP. And this the whole things what you are talking. It just depends on 0 and 1. These are binary numbers. And the whole thing is generated by these two numbers. Okay? So this is what is the best example for those who are talking the application of algebra in informatics. Okay. So that's why, so they different name for a take given for this is small. Now move slowly and slowly. Okay, we take another type of structure, but things are started, and this is not new, but this started very early. So, but it is the importance of algebra of this structure was gradually increased day by day, year by day. Okay, now we are shifting to more general. Type of this ring that is called now consider this type of you know the GPNP is time and is but is move first part this type of
so dear friends, this is the beauty of this small structure. We call smallest field of order 2. So we that's why we pick up this second wonder of algebra is ring of integer modulo n. And see later on the whole information science now shifted to may create the interest for algebraist. We will discuss later on because we are moving from here. This is we construct many other means. We give you personalize the use of this ring in coding theory. Okay, from where it create the new history for algebraist. Okay, and then how has connection in the cryptography. And last, recent application of this beautiful structure are image processing. So we discuss later on about these beautiful properties and also about you know the role of this ring in graph theory. So these four area are make this algebra is more popular. So people, let me discuss with you also. What you think about algebra as a subject? It is pure mathematics or applied mathematics? Please, I want to know among the participants, how you look algebra as a pure mathematics or as applied mathematics? Anyone? Pure mathematics. Yes, more answer. Now it becomes the area for research interdisciplinary. Because first we talk about the mathematics, mean pure part of these structures, and then we use these structures in applied science, like as I told you, applied mathematics, are science of communication, coding theory, cryptography. Cryptography, you many of know, is not basically mathematics, but now it it makes mathematics more interesting. Okay, toward the security, everyone keep their mobile in login always, because he or she never want to see her or his message by his friend or by his sister or brother, even parents. They are always mobile, don't want to see message to see any one of them. That is called, you know, the secrecy. Secrecy is based on the cryptography, and the idea of the secrecy is based on security, based on these rings. Okay, so in my point of view, it is interdisciplinary area. You call it pure mathematics, you call it applied mathematics, okay, but it has root in every field, and that's why we call it is, you know, the interdisciplinary. And nowadays is a very good funding on this is area are available. I have very big project. If some of you know the King Abdullah City of Science and Technology, cost Saudi Arabia. So we have team around more than 15 algebraists, not only algebraists, they are computer science, mathematics, and the other areas as well from America, from Australia, and from Canada, Italy, and Norway, Saudi Arabia, India as well. We have around 10, 20 countries, and we have big funding. If somebody has good publication in cryptography or coding theory towards interest in the security, we have an offer for postdoc at King Abdullah City of Science Technology in collaboration of King Abdullah University Jeddah under this project. So it has very good, very nice applications nowadays. So let us move on another. Yes, so I hope you understand why we call second wonder of mathematics, in particular algebra, is ring of integer modulo 2. And in particular field, that is Z2, just mentioned in the board, Z2. Okay. Any question about this wonder or any suggestion? So we move on next one, that is field. Anyhow, because I make connection for the second and first, okay? Where n is prime, then the ring of integer modulo n becomes, you know, field, okay? So the smallest field, we have already discussed this, we call the smallest field, and see its application. Very short, we say small, but it has great application in the field of information science, in the field of in electrical engineering, in medical science as well. Okay, so this is the about the field, and if we go in more advanced version, then we just write down in the down, Zp to the power n, the field of order p of characteristic p, okay, of order n. So in general, this is the field which associate with the ring integer modulo n. So next wonder is ring of polynomials. ring of polynomials has, because it has close connection with the, with, you know, the polynomials. Just we talk about the first wonder, fundamental theorem of algebra, because fundamental theorem of algebra has close, because the connection with the polynomials, behavior of the polynomials, polynomial equations. Okay, so a ring of polynomial means you collect the polynomials, entries of these polynomials is from rings, and then you form a new ring. At that new ring, we call ring of polynomials. And this third wonder of algebra has same importance as the second and third, because this also changed the, you know, whole information science, mainly coding theory and cryptography. Why? We discuss later on the construction, but in briefly, this make, you know, the coding theory, even ring of polynomials, has its own importance, because it is a structure, new structure, has beautiful properties. You define addition, multiplication, and then you can find out irreducibility of the polynomials. And you know, when we are talking about the irreducibility of polynomial, this is what make connection with the fundamental theorem of algebra. Because there are two types of, you know, the polynomials which are, has great application in information science, is irreducible polynomials. Because irreducible polynomials play a very, very important role in cryptography and in coding theory. With the help of irreducible polynomials, in fact, we construct a new ring according our demand, according our need in coding theory or in the cryptography to make, if we are talking the cryptographical part, to make this ring, and then consider the course of this ring. And course in coding theory, we pick up the course from these rings. Okay, so this gives the beautiful structural properties of various kind of course, like linear course, cyclic course, and the other type of course. And in cryptography part, we use this structure, okay, to construct a security in place of, you know, we taking integer or prime numbers, we will pick up the elements of the ring, this type of ring, and then we make security. So the security becomes is more and more strong, because nowadays the one of the best problem in the cryptography is how to make your crypto system more secure. So for the more secure, we need beautiful structure or the bigger structure where the man who trying to destroy the security cannot reach on the numbers what he or she can imagine. So this part is make more and more secure when we consider the crypto system over ring of polynomials. So this is what we will call four wonders of algebra. And now let us move how we construct these things. Go to the real mathematics. What are the real mathematics behind this system? Means how you construct ring of integer modulo n, how you construct Rx, then the use of this or application of these structures in the field of coding theory, cryptography, image processing, and graph theory. So let's move on the next one. So this is the next discussion. We will talk about the Jesus, that means idea, and then be construction and decomposition. And these are the applications we are going to be discuss based on the above construction. So in this construction, we use the basic mathematics. Step by step, give you idea how to reach on this level by using very, very elementary mathematics. Okay. So come on. These are the, I quote, if you look on, three reference, one by one. How make ring theory more interesting for the coding theory? How make algebra is more interesting for coding theorists? Okay, and that was the paper published in the year 1994. One of my collaborator, this is the, you know, Patrick Soul, is one of the author of this paper, and A.R. Kumar, this is one of the Indian. So this is the first landmark paper in coding theory, which makes algebra more applicable. From, that means people move from field theory to ring theory. Before that paper, most of the literature in coding theory and cryptography, they are using the field. Just we mentioned on the board, Z2, only Z2, not anyone. And this paper, and you make difference, Z2 and Z4. So now here is this Z4. Z2 is the field of order 2. However, Z4 is not a field. Yes, are you agreeing? Yes, this is a ring of order 4. Okay, so that means the first step, first paper on coding theory that change or make abstract algebra more applicable and more interesting. Okay, transfer from a field, finite field, to finite ring. This is the first landmark paper in coding theory. And then second one is, this is what for coding theory, cryptography part. This is for cryptography part. Using the ring theory in the security, based on this terminology, we call AMDS matrix. The AMDS term is very close to the terminology of coding theory. Maximum distance, like its name is AMDS, okay? Maximum distance syndrome. So what happens, in fact, in this area, the matrix, this MDS matrix, the integer of this matrix from ring theory, Zn, ring of integer modulo n. So the, again, this gives a new direction for people who is working in cryptography, okay, how to use abstract algebra, purely ring theory in cryptography. So the entities of these matrices is from ring, and the ring is based on the construction, how construct the ring from a given ring, okay? So this is another issue. And the last one is application of ring theory in segmentation of digital image processing information. This is how to use ring theory to make your photo more beautiful. Okay, so this is sometimes, you know, behind the imagination, okay, he, how this behave these structures. Okay, this is what the beauty of algebra. We are talking, this give three applications. The fourth one is using ring theory in graph theory, because nowadays graph theory also play a very, very important role in applied sciences. Okay, and the best example, I'm not mentioned here, but because we are talking the applications, so at least I must mention the role of ring theory in abstract algebra in graph theory. Okay, maybe some of you are from graph theory background, or anyone researcher from graph theory? Yes, so I think you must know the what is the best problem of graph theory and what are the application to the real life problems. I quote, how to like your city is, when I coming from my hotel, it will take 30 minutes. The question is, how we minimize this time? It means we have direct road to reach here, this is 5 to 10 minutes. So how can we do it? This is what the problem of graph theory. This is what the problem of graph theory. And if you first problem graph theory on the based on the same theme. Okay. Anyway, so these are the, I quote the four applications of ring theory, algebra in the different area. Okay. Let us move on the tools. What tools we used to create such beautiful mathematics. And these tools, my dear brothers and sisters, they are not new. The tools are obvious because they are known tools. Okay? And these known tools create the beautiful things, as we discussed. So let us highlight some of them. Okay. So first tool is equivalence relation. How the equivalence relation help us to construct a new structure from the given permission. My last application I'm talking about segmentation, image processing. Okay, so I just give you the particular example of equivalence classes. You collect images, define the relation. Okay, and define, we need two relations for construction of ring, that is addition and multiplication. So we define the relation in such way which fulfill our requirement. Requirement is what? Addition operation and multiplication. So it make a new structure that is called a ring. So in segmentation or image processing, if you collect the images pixel by pixel, okay, and add them by some rule and multiply by another rule, you will form a structure, and that structure be called a ring. So ring in term of digital science, new coin, new area, okay, in image processing. Then, okay, so we define this very structural, because this is very important. So I just point out it, why we use these tools, means the basic raw material for our smart things, okay? So as is non-empty set, then we define the relation, reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. If this happens on non-empty set, then non-empty set we call, the relation is called, this relation we have defined is called equivalence relation. And then we make a collection of all these equivalence classes. So like this, I just move a very precise example so a layman can understand what is going on. Okay, these are the equivalence classes. We have relation of be an unempty set, first requirement, then relation. And we will check this origin equivalence relation by set that means satisfy all properties, what we are talking. And these are the examples, C1, C2 equivalence class. So these equivalence class, in fact, make your an algebraic structure in large. Then we define equivalence class on integers because the objective is to first, sorry, the second wonders, how to construct the second wonder of algebra, that is the ring of integer modulo n. So we are proceeding to construct this, and that's why we give you the basic tools how to make it as a ring. Okay, so again we define this the structure on and positive, then we define this difference and this satisfy Theorem's law, symmetry, reflexive and transitivity. So that means the R with this relation becomes, this relation becomes equivalence relation on set of integers. And now we are going to collect these set of equivalence classes. So these are equivalence classes of set integer. After that, because this set integers, this is of course infinite set, okay? Yes, this is infinite set, means order infinite number of element in Z. Yeah, and Zn, this set we are going to construct is finite. That means we collect the finite number of elements, and these finite number of elements are equivalence classes. And what are the equivalence classes? So these are the equivalence classes. 0, 1, 2. So this is what, and then this give you, look at this set here. D6. So this is finite, that is collection of equivalent classes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 number. This is set of having 6 elements. And later on, we will call it ring of order 6. Okay. And so we are going to construct this ring from Z to Zn. Okay. So what is ring? This is the definition. I am not going to go give detail because this is familiar to all of you. But just I point out, this is the ring has, let me check all these property in that set we are going to construct. Okay. I'm not, then we will move on. Yes. Field, some additional property. These are the field. From students, please make difference between ring and field. That means for a ring is called field if non-zero elements form a group under multiplication. So that means if a ring has such property, if A is element, non-zero element of R, then A inverse also in R, then this structure or this ring we call field. And here the inverse element is very important because this is what play the significant role in the field theory, because ring does not have such properties. Okay, when you have one element and you need the another element, if you multiply this element, you will get the multiplicative identity. So this property is the key property in field theory, field. Okay. And then, yeah. How much time we have? Yes. How much time, please? One hour, okay. So look, the construction we define the, because in order to construct a ring, we need addition, multiplication of conjugate classes. Okay, so these are the two operations, means we define addition in such a way and multiplication. And with these two operations, this structure, like, you know, this one form a ring, and we call it finite ring of order n. So from infinite set, we construct a ring with the help of equivalence classes, okay? With the help of equivalence relation, right? And we get this beautiful structure that is finite ring. And this is what we call the second bundle of algebra. Right? Now, and then of course, there are, because with through this ring, we will approach towards the field. Okay? So, let us have some remark which makes Zn a field. So, the first one is, as I told, we call equivalence classes. Now, we call residue classes. The same terminology we are used. So, this residue class A bar in Zn is invertible if GCD of A and N is 1. Then second, the residual class ring Zn is a field if and only if N is prime. Prime number has its own importance in mathematics. Okay, so you see the one importance is if your N is prime, then this ring becomes a field. That means every ring is not a field. So from ring to make a field, we need some additional things. And these additional things, we have to check what are the additional things. So the first additional point, how to get inverse of the element. It may be means multiplicative inverse, because additive was abelian. Okay. So, and then if you remove zero from these equivalence classes, still you have another structure, and that is the multiplicative group. Multiplicative group play also very important role in cryptography when choosing this crypto system. This is another application point above from group theory. Okay, and so these two set we have already mentioned in the beginning. Okay, on the board. And now here point is to see the behavior of these elements. Means difference, because the behavior of these elements, in fact, make it more interesting. So some rings which we are going to use in cryptography is not all specified rings. And what are these specified rings? So we are, that's why I mentioned this point, and see the behavior of elements. So if you look this table, addition, then this is multiplication, then observation from above table. What we say, that two does form a field, indeed. It is the smallest field. It is the smallest field. We call it Galois field, as mentioned in the notice board. Okay. Again, the Galois field, this Galois field make algebra is very beautiful. okay, and more interesting. So this is the first structure which is has great importance and great things in abstract algebra. Then three is okay, because three is also field, the three is prime, so we not go on much detail, but look at four. Means make difference Z2 and Z4. Z2 is a field, sorry, field, but Z4 is not field. So what are the difference? And this difference make such rings useful in cryptography. So let us see the observation, because you know already know the multiplication table and everything here. You check the inverse and the rest things. The other important part is Z4 does not form a field. I think it's easy for everyone. Any student backside, please, Satya. Why this is not field? Could you answer this question? Why Z4 is not field? Anyone from PG students? No. This is basic question. Is means undergraduate level, because when somebody has studied. Anyway, it's not. But I think sometimes you look around here and there, you find the answer. So that's why I'm asking, don't take the load on your head, just looking towards the board or sometimes the other side, then you may find the answer. The answer is already on board. If you can look the board, already on the board. Okay, but I just want to check who is alert and who is looking to the slide. So answer is here. 2 does not have inverse. It's already on. That's why I'm asking, okay? So this make, this D4 does not has a field structure. That means non-zero element does not have inverse in Z4, okay? Other important aspect is units in Z4. This is very, very important point, because this point or this last observation make ring theory entry into the cryptography. The MDS matrix we have just already discussed to you, the entry of these MDS matrices is from unit element of the ring, in fact. Okay, so the entry of ring theory in cryptography by these elements. So units in Z4 is 1 and 4. I hope you know the definition of unit elements. If A is in R and find B element, or there exists B such that the multiplication of both is 1. That means the unity. Okay. So such element we call unit element. So in Z4, 1 and 3 are unit limits. So this type of observation make these structure are more interesting. In fact, before the cryptography, we are not thinking on these issues, because as algebraists or as graduate students at PG, then we are thinking on these issues. These point, in fact, raised by person who are working in information science. One of my friend in Norway, he asked me, because he did his PhD in computer science, so he visited me, and he asked me, Roshaki, do you let me know what element, means you have element, if you multiply them, you will get one. So what type of this element ring has, which are the ring which has this property, and how many elements of this type? And before, nobody asked this question. And then we are thinking on this issue. And this issue, in fact, gives the direction for algebraized entry in the cryptography in segmentation, image processing. The entries coming from this type of properties. Anyhow, this the function sometimes when we take the order of field in cryptography or coding theory, so we denote the order of this field or such type of rings by phi n, and this is called phi function, is very important in number theory, and it has similar some significance in cryptography like that. And then decomposition of Pareto classics. This is the second point of entry of rings in coding theory, okay, via number theory. So because in coding theory, we have direct sum and direct product of rings, and in that we constructed new rings. So this is the decomposition via Chinese remainder theorem. Is a very well known topic in the number theory. So if somebody interested can check this one. Means we decompose these rings in with the help of finite rings to form a new ring, and that new rings again is interesting for coding theory. So this is what we are talking, the construction of this. So let me give you the example so you easily understand. Like this D6, okay? How to make this D6 with the help of D2 and Z3. So this is the construction and decomposition, I give you example, okay? For the requirement of our study in coding theory. And another tool, as I told you, last wonder of algebra is ring of polynomials, the entry of polynomials in the coding theory. So let R be a commutative ring, okay, with unity, then this type of expression is well known for our effect. We call polynomials over rings. And if you collect all these polynomials, they then be form Rx. Under addition and multiplication is the, you know, the polynomials, and this is area is in test otherwise. And this ring as we have called fourth wonder of algebra, okay? So this one, then we have how many questions related to the number of elements in the field or in rings. So I think we will leave out this, and we are going to another construction from field. We combined field and polynomial to construct new kind of rings, which becomes the tool for coding theorists. Okay, so this is the first kind of construction from with the help of polynomial. So in order to construct these rings, we again need some basic things like factorization of polynomial. And once we are talking about the factorization of polynomial, you know the first wonder, fundamental theorem of algebra. Okay, we decide how to factorize polynomial, how many roots it has, it is reducible polynomial or irreducible polynomial. So if polynomial is irreducible, and then it forms a great good things. And that is the construction based on irreducible polynomials. Okay. So look at the Galois field of order n. G of p to the power n. Okay. And I ask one question from the student. Please feel free to, means participate, don't sigh. Any one of you has wish to create something in mathematics by your own name, as you have in your friend, that is, we call Galois field. So any one of you has such wish to create some notations in mathematics known as by your name? Yes, please stand. This is concerned with the students, especially undergraduate students. Oh, no one has. Surprise. Must have at least, you know, wish. Everyone want to earn more money. Yes? This, everyone has such type of wish, need more money, more fame, more. So nobody need any such type of thing. Yeah, go ahead, guys, go ahead. Come on. After discussion, come on, no problem. Oh, surprise. My dear students, a man can do what man has done. A man can do what man has done. Please. Anyone make translation of this statement in the Indonesian so the students understand well? Anyone faculty member, please? Anyone make translation of this quotation? A man can do what man has done in Indonesia. So I hope the student not understand this well. So they must understand the meaning, what I'm saying. Come on, please, come on, because I want to also know the Indonesian, how to convert it in Indonesia. Yeah. No, just tell them in Indonesia. I'm going to again quote. A man can do what man has done. What man has done. Man has done. The example is, I just give you an example, hopefully you understand. If Galois create this field, so it known his name, Galois field. So Satya can do the same thing, I known as Satya field. Do you understand? So that's why a man can do what man has done. At least this is what I want. This is very important message. Okay. This is someone of you must have such imagination, such wish And if you have beautiful means wish, ask Allah, inshallah, one day it must be fulfilled because Allah is Rabbul Alameen. He can give anything for the human beings, because human being is the best creation by Allah. So for those who have wish to do something and ask Allah, inshallah, Allah will give you one day, another day. So remember three things, because at this point I mention you. First is, a man can do what man has done. If somebody is the prime minister or president of Indonesia, yes, you can be the prime minister or president of the Indonesia in the future. But what is the requirement? The requirement is hard work is the key of success. Hard work is key for your room, key for your car, key for your two-wheeler, key of your president office is the same term, but using in different categories. That's why hard work is one term, but it gives the beautiful things later on. So hard work is the key of success. Okay? This third point, if you want to become a scientist, definitely you will read mathematics or other things, they get doctorate degree. But if you want to become the prime minister, the president of Indonesia, then what to do? Apart from this, you need the politics, Indonesian politics. So you must follow the rules of the things what you need to be. But I believe Allah will give you, if you have wish and if you have ambitions and if you have the clear vision for these things. And rest things leave on Allah. Okay? He's Rabbul Alameen. He can give you everything, whatever you wish. But must have wish. So that's why must, at least I hope some of a student come up and say, yes, I want to in the future. I feel really great because this is what the aim, to give you the motivation, okay, to the younger generation, how to come forward for the future of your country, to fame your country. Quote you. This is basically for faculty members. I am very sorry to let you know that about the field medal. Okay, see the position of your country in Nobel Prize. See the position of your country. Hardly you find the name. I know about the field medal because this is my interest of topic. I never know anyone from Indonesia, no one from Malaysia, no one from Dubai, nobody from Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, nobody from Kuwait, nobody from Morocco, nobody from Turkey. This is the situation, guys. And this is the point of thinking, why not your country? Why not among you? So, the faculty member of this university, convey this message to your higher administration. Okay? Where you stand in the higher education. And what is the requirement? How you can go in this area to give the fame of your country? What are the necessary things And I am really happy if any one of you or your administration need how to promote, how to create such type of institutions in Indonesia or in your university. I'm really very happy because I'm talking on this from last few years in Turkey, in Morocco, Iran, Saudi Arabia, many places I pointed out this issue. See where we are, except Iran. Because before last 2018, the only Iranian lady, that was the only Muslim, only the woman who got the field medal, and only the Muslim country who got the field medal. So this is very, very important point to note for the faculty members, how to train your young generation for the future. I hope you will convince my this remark and keep forward with this remark to your administration or elders. Let us move on mathematical talking. Sometimes these points are important because we don't have much more time to give the separate discussion on the GSU. So I make this point in the front of you and hope you can forward this message to larger level to think on the GSU and make your country proud. Yes, this is the map where Indonesia, this is the map, this is the pupil where you are them. Please. So let us come back on the mathematical, technical aspect of the discussion. We are going to construct a ring that is with the help of polynomial. And what type of polynomial? Irreducible polynomial. Okay, that is the make use of first wonders of algebra. To decide polynomial has root or not. Okay. So this P is called characteristics of this field, and then the GF is called prime. Prime field means has no other field. Okay. So then let PX be an irreducible polynomial of degree n in JPX. So for each irreducible polynomial, we always generate a maximal ideal. For each irreducible polynomial, we have a maximal ideal. And once we have a maximal ideal, we can construct a quotient ring with the help of this maximal ideal. And that quotient ring is beautifully become a field. Because if you have a ring, commutative ring with identity, and I am is the maximal ideal, then quotient ring R upon F is a field. So we construct a field with the help of polynomials, irreducible polynomials. And that field again becomes, that ring again becomes a ring, a field, and that field is a quotient ring. Okay, so look at here, we have a GP and this is the irreducible polynomial. Okay, so this is the ideal, in fact, is the most ideal generated by, this is a polynomial. And this is ideal generated by this PF. So this in fact, the quotient ring is a field of cardinality P to the power N and known as Galois field. Another type of field apart from Zn. Okay, these are construction. So in coding theory and cryptography, this type of construction is play a very, very important role. So let us So this is the demonstration to construct a field of order 4. In fact, you know, Z4 is not field, just we mentioned before. Yes, Z4 is not a field, as we mentioned before, because every non-zero element does, 2 is non-zero element, but 2 does not have inverse. 2 into 2 is 4, and that is 0 in Z4, that means 2 does not have multiplicative inverse, as we mentioned before. However, we can construct, even then we can construct a field of that order by a polynomial. And that polynomial is this last wonder of algebra. And this polynomial ring or this type of field are the key point in coding theory. Okay, look at. So look at this construction, and then we call this alpha. In fact, alpha is the, you know, this is the primitive root. I just point out because we're using some number theory also. So this is primitive root, and then we form, because for ring we need again an addition operation and multiplication. So these are the table which fulfill your requirement. Multiplication table with the help of this alpha element of 0, 1, alpha, 1 plus alpha. These are the elements. So this is the field of order 4 constructed with the help of irreducible polynomial. And now this is the key ingredient in coding theory. And then let me move fast because of time. I'm just going to highlight the last part. What we did till now in this field. Okay, because the middle part I am going to skip and go to the last part to show you, or someone are interested in this area, can we find direct reference of my research in this area. So I think I move and to the, this is what our coding theory part. So now we this part give you the application of ring theory in cryptography. Okay. So quickly see on the structure. A square matrix A is an MDS matrix if and only every square sum matrix of A is non-singular. The beautiful thing is here, look at the ring Z5, and entries of this matrix is from this ring. So if it has such type of matrix, then we call these matrices are MDS matrix. If all submatrix are non-singular. This is condition. And then if we have these matrices, in then we form the RSC system. And in each of the when we construct the crypto system, if the entries of the crypto system taken via these matrices, and this then make the crypto system is more strong. So someone cannot destroy our, you know, the secrecy is quickly, it need a lot of time because it involves something which is not looking outside, because MDS matrix then go to the ring, and the ring you have a special type of ring, as I told you, unit element sometimes. So it's not easy to catch or to break the secrecy. To make a strong password in general, you need such type of strong the structure behind this mathematical observations. Now I move another part. Okay, so this is what we are talking, RSC system. In cryptography, and the recent one is the elliptical cryptography, where the idea has and play an important role. this is some, because using some mathematics to demonstrate, but we not have much more time to explain, and then we keep it up to you. And if somebody are in thesis, definitely go to ask me for exact reference or anything. So this part is related to image processing, that is in segmentation, okay? So the key point in that part is, because once we are talking about the segmentation or image processing, so we have different pictures and the person is far away from here, and you have his or her old picture, like very early stage, like your family member, suppose he have some picture and he is now left the country, he was in Canada or America, he shifted 2, 4, 5 decades before. So how we recognize he is the, who is that guy? Is correct man we are thinking or not? So this help us to recognize the correct person, okay, who is that guy? That is called image processing in general. So where we have the elements of this ring, pixel by many photos, pixels, and apply these, the equivalence classes as we discussed before, and study the behavior of these pixels by our ring theory, okay? So the elements are from where? Look at here. Look at this last theorem here. The set GK, any matrix of K by K over second bundles. Matrix, entries of this matrix is from Gn. And Gn, which Gn? Because we have similar Gn, which has maximum number of units in that Gn. So we choose a such ring which has maximum number of units. Okay? And of course, this is what we are talking about. What is it? We are talking about as a structure, as algebra. So we are interested in what is the additive identity, what is the ultimate multiplicative identity, so on and so forth. So in terms of picture, what is the additive identity and what is the multiplicative identity is very interesting question. So anyway, this is a brief description of these things. Okay, so look how we make this as a ring and how we define the operations. So also this is the result. We have code here through the equivalence classes. And the equivalence classes is the images here, okay? And then we define the operation as previously, okay? So this is a few examples. When you put on net segmentation, you look very beautiful pictures, and they are very famous and common pictures like this, okay? So using this structure to make all things to be more visible. And this, I think, yeah, no equivalence classes. Come to conclude part. This is the, these are the few papers where we have the, these papers are already published in all area we are talking, okay, coding theory and cryptography. So look at all these papers from last 2022 or 23. So recent work in this area. So if somebody are interested, please check the detail and look at first, this is what construction of quantum course over the class of commutative rings and their application to DNA course. And regarding the DNA code, DNA coding, I point, just give you the brief view of DNA coding, DNA computing, maybe heard the name. They are very famous topic, DNA associated with medical terminology, okay? Genetic information, to pass genetic informations. On the other hand, if we're talking about DNA computing, that means to move the quantum computing. And both area are very, very challenging for research. DNA as a medical science is also a challenging area. And DNA computing in information science, it is the area where now people are interesting how to create supercomputing. Okay, so these are the very, very challenging area of research in this direction. So if somebody has some interest, and go ahead on these papers, and you can find some more recent work in this area. And then, last part regarding cryptography. Ring theory based cryptography. So the last paper is based on this one's non-existence of some, the MDS matrix over finite rings. So as we're talking to introduce the ring theory in cryptography. So this is the, there are also some paper, if you click on that one, means you can, then you can go inside and there are one or two paper more, but this is just have an idea how to replace field theory part in by ring theory. So with this, I suppose to start because I noticed the faces you are waiting for stuff. So I think we are going to move in. These are some, okay. So thank you very much to all of you for listening. For 2 hours, it's not easy to sit. Okay, so, okay. And thank you. Now you are free to ask any some questions, some clarification, or other things.
Check. Thank you for Professor Dr. Shakir Ali for extraordinary session today. We hope we will have learn about this more with you, maybe, and we will have a collaboration research with you. From the presentation, we can conclude for wonder of algebra. Number one is FTA, fundamental theorem of algebra, and Zn, the ring of integer modulo n, F, and the field, and Rx, the ring of polynomials. And next agenda is Q&A session. For offline participants, you can raise your hand for ask question, and for the online participants, you can write your question on room chat. Thank you.
Yes, please come forward. Come forward. Yes. If you have any question, ask.
Thank you for. I want to ask about the four wonders of algebra. In four wonders of algebra, in PowerPoint, it only mentioned rings and field structure. Are other structures not as popular as these two types of structures, such as modules, vector space, and other structures maybe? And then I want to ask you about is there any relation between the four wonders of algebra as an algebra structure? Maybe one item is a suffering for other one, or other relation maybe. Thank you.
Well, good question. At least someone came out to ask a question. But I just suggest to the students, always try to ask something to the speaker, because if you ask something, then you must be think before. That means you maybe note down something and alert, okay, to ask your clarification or to ask your ideas. So it is good, in fact, to ask the question. Okay, so thank you. What is your name? Abdul. Okay, so well, his question was, as I understand, what is the relation between these four bundles, or what about the others? Yes, I'm right. Your question is about what about the other structures like vector space modules? Yes. Yes, of course, there is a scope, but we always have, you know, the priority wise, because we are talking about the wonders. The wonders are those who really wonders, not how to define and how to make the things interested, connect the human beings. So in such way, we choose such wonders. Okay, like there are some, if you're talking about wonders from mathematics, today's agenda is different, wonders from algebra. If you're talking wonders from mathematics, then I can add some more, like matrix theory, matrices. Okay, it's very beautiful. It play many, many important role in various field of life, from medical, from commerce, from economics, from other areas. So yes, there is a wonders, but depend on the situation, depend on the audience, and depend on the need of time. Because today we are talking wonders from algebra, so in my view, these four are the best wonders, because you if you look on these, how they change the life, how they change the society, okay? Make everything easy. Distance does not matter. Time does not matter sometimes. So that's why we choose all these four wonders. Maybe if somebody has some other explanation, can choose others one, but you need to explanation about these wonders. Okay, thank you.
Thank you for the answer, sir. For other participants, maybe have questions, you can raise your hand.
Yes, welcome.
Okay. Thanks for the I have question for Professor Shakir. For many research you do, have you ever felt stuck while you're doing your researches? If you have, how was you overcome that?
Very good question. What is your name?
My name's Aisha.
Ahia.
Aisha.
Ahia.
Aisha.
What is Aisha? Okay. So very good meaning. But yes, Aisha. Mashallah, very good. So she asked a very fantastic question. Okay. Have a problem, how to overcome it. So we face several times the problem, because life is, you know, itself, you know, the things, the collection of problems. But whenever we have such problems, we never afraid. We try to see it in the positive. Means, suppose during my, like I give you one example. When I was in research, And then my mentor was on extraordinary leave, and he left the university to King Abdulaziz University for 5 years. And 2 years already passed, so we left 3 years. And this is, I think, the middle of the career. And I am very much in, you know, face problem ki how will handle, because he has gone and left me at this stage. And then I think so many bad things in life. Now this is end of life. I go evening, I think it was Maghrib or Isha. I'm not exactly remember time, but I was in the house of Allah and pray namaz. After namaz, I will just ask to Allah what I do, because it must be either go back to my home without doctorate degree, or how it make possible. So, you know, whenever and then after asking Allah, and Allah give the strength. Suppose he was died, then what happened? Because he's not going, so at least we can make connection by email or by post. Suppose he is died, then what we can do? We must think the alternative. So that make me again give the energy. Still, he is not in India, but he will be in some other place. We make connection 1 year after 2 years. So it gives the positive energy. I come back and again start my work, and in that way, okay, let us see what happened. But inshallah, Allah will help us. So in that way, I start work and I make something to communicate him. I wrote a letter to him. We have such and such situation. What your idea? And the man who I just mentioned, the Professor Ashraf, he reply me, don't worry, you do your work and send me, I will check, and I am with you. So you don't lose anything. So these, his two line really give the new energy for me. Okay, let me stand on the solution. So ultimately, after alhamdulillah, few years, we got the solution of his problem. So this is the first instance that happens with me. I understand?
Yes, thank you for the answer.
So the message is, to follow a question, whenever you have a problem, and we know every problem has a solution. May not be at that time, same time, but after some time. So don't lose your stamina. Don't lose your your faith, what you have inside. Always be bold. Yes, inshallah, we will fight it, and one day we will win. We will be winner. So do not lose your stamina, and always think positive about yourself. What you have, it is enough to give you the light in the world. These words is very important, because you have many things inside, but only you need a pupil who just bring what you have inside to the front of the pupil. So you need such type of mentors, such type of elders. They may be your parents, they may be your teachers, they may be your countrymen, or it may be any human being whom you associate one way another. Okay, so don't lose your stamina. Think positive about your strength. Always count your strength, what strength you have, and try to explore among the others. So inshallah, one day you will be the winner. Okay, any other question? Yes.
Okay,
could you pass the mic, please?
Thank you for your sharing, Prof. Shakir. I want to ask, what are the example of the topics of in algebra for the undergraduate student thesis.
Okay, very, very. So they're relevant to the students. So she is thinking, my dear students, because there are I noticed many graduate students. So as I feel, your teacher is always thinking about yourself. See, he's asking topic for you, not anything from research, but she's eager to know what are the best topics for the undergraduate students. Am I right? Yeah, okay. In linear algebra, or in general. So, according my point of view, choose different topic for different student and see the strength of the student and interest of the students. What is the next step after graduation? What he or she will interest, for example. If somebody is interesting, we are talking in coding theory, give the topic related to partially to the coding theory. So it will help to the students to decide the next journey. Okay. Similarly, if somebody what topic you choose in algebra for coding theory people, so my suggestion in that is very good. Ask the student the behavior of ring of integer module n, and give her or him time, okay, and to elaborate. I discussed Z4, Z6, ask them to make surgery. Surgery means what are the tools we need when we do doctor go in the theater to make surgery. Lot of things they need before. So he or she read this topic as a medical. Clear, write each and everything in open and give chance to think. As structural properties, what are the properties of the element? What are the unit? What are the identity? What is role of the identity? For example, I ask one question to the students. Can Satya let me know what your identity? What is your identity? Yes. Because this is discussion asking question in algebra. So I ask a question from algebra to demonstrate what does mean of the identity. Okay. So identity, we are talking group or ring or field. So that's why I'm asking, what is your identity? How make identity with the real life? Means how connect mathematics with yourself or ourselves. So it make more interesting. Yes. Okay. And another. I talking of identity as a family member. So it make more connection to the mathematics. As a family, what is your identity? So, dear academic friends, I give you the example about this identity of group or ring or field, how to make it us together as a human being, association with mathematics with a human being. Like my name is...
Selamat siang semua.
Akhir Ali.
Selamat.
So, Shakir Ali, for right now I'm talking, Shakir Ali from India. So, if we're talking my identity, so first identity, I'm Indian. Okay, when we go to hotel, they ask you, we give you a passport. So, this is my identity as India. As a family, my name is Shakir Ali. So that means I build, my first name is Shakir and surname is Ali. So Ali means my father name. So Shakir Ali, that means I associate with the family, Ali family, Khan family. Okay. So this is me to associate my family, my father, and India associate me in India as identity, as Indian, as Indian. So this make mathematics associate with the society. So I'm asking your identity means your identity regarding your family. A good answer, at least you say, as a student of this university. So first identity, if you associate with the university, so your identity is University of Delhi. So if you match this type of things with the pupil, then it make mathematics more interesting and more understandable. People understand what you're doing, what you're talking. And the second topic, like somebody interesting, like in the linear algebra. Okay, so give the linear transformation, because linear algebra has to do with linear transformation. Any topic from the linear algebra. If somebody has interest in cryptography, ask them to study field theory, because it's more important in field theory. So in that way, you can pick up these topics, like some topic from abstract algebra, some topic from linear algebra. Okay, I think it makes sense to explore that. If somebody is more interested in some particular area, like I'm talking like many places about derivation, my core research area. So I have discussion on this one. So I think two students, Adli and Evan, they're presenting on derivation. I was very impressed because they are undergraduate students and they make presentation on that topic, new one. So that's his and her interest. So topic is totally related with the student's decision and student's opinion, what he wish to the next step. So that may helpful to her or him to go in the right direction. Yes. There's any other question, please? Okay. Mic, please.
We know that Zn is mostly using for the crypto system. Is there any crypto system which is construct from? Thank you, Prof. Sakir.
Well, looking very good question in with reference to the cryptography. Yes, there is a crypto system based on the elliptic curve. So elliptical means you have the curve is the point lie on that curve. So this is always have infinite dimension. So this is one of the crypto system where an empty curve crypto system. And basically, crypto system based on the the polynomial. You have a polynomial of degree 3, something like, and then it has the solution of the points. Okay, it is big domain. It has independent area. On that part, it will be the infinite dimension on this thing. But I am not have much more detail about such crypto system. Yeah. Nice. Coding. Much difference. Both are different. They are different. But crypto system basically the you know the whole sole part of your secrecy. Security is yeah. This is related to the secrecy of your messages. So nobody can read your message. So make something wrong or something good not. So this is this secrecy impact. Like most people nowadays, like World Bank has funded projects on the basis how to make more and more powerful crypto system. So people cannot be destroyed this crypto system. This is the challenging problem nowadays for the cryptologists people. Many funding agencies, World Bank, the other banks, they are ready to pay, like IBM. IBM is ready to pay any type of amount if somebody can go and work with IBM on supercomputing or on these crypto systems. Yeah.
Thank you for all participants because the time is over. Finally, we have come to the end part of this lecture sessions. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you to the speakers, Prof. Shakir Ali, for his informative and interesting presentation, and also to all participants for active participations. Please give applause for the speakers. Thank you. So see you all. And thank you very much. See you later and the next session. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thanks for Muhammad Syed for bringing us to lecture session today. The next agenda is awarding session. We would like to invite for the extraordinary speaker, Professor Shakir Ali, and the and we would like to invite the Governor of Indonesian Mathematical Society for Central Java and DIY Regency, Dr. Bagus Ardi Saputro, to give the certificate and souvenir for Professor Shakir Ali.
Jadi buat untuk gambar suara supaya lebih kondusif aja.
Thanks for Professor Shakir Ali and Dr. Bagus Ardi Saputro. Then I'd like to write some announcement for the participants now. First, for the online participants, you need to fulfill the presence form for session one. We also remind you that the second session of the lecture series will be held on today at 1 p.m. in Universitas Islam Negeri Wali Songo. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of lecture series, Exploring the Wonders of Algebra, We would like to say thank you for your active participation today and have a great rest of your day. See you in the second lecture series. I am Aisyah Nur Adila signing off. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you.